this is probably for me also the happiest and the most exciting presentation. I think that after, obviously, Patricia's great popularity, and also after her presentation just 2 weeks ago here at Domus Academy, no any more introduction is needed. But I just wanted to point out something that for me it's very important and in general for the school. I just like to say that for me personally, Patricia has been in the last years the person who has most affected in a way and also well-oriented my way of being, my way of working, my way of teaching. And I say that also in the last year she has really given a lot at this school. But especially I think that thanks to her and thanks to her constant contribution, we really understand how every project and every opportunity should be a very important occasion to understand ourselves, to understand our identity, and to understand how the project should really become our own personal expression. You know everything about her, so the list of the companies she has been collaborating with in the last year, she's really endless, with the great last addition, because a few months ago you've been appointed also director, artistic director of Cassina, so every day great, every month I say that great challenges and new great experiences are coming out. And in this great experience, that I think that every time Patricia, she is able to, in a way, start from scratch, to rethink everything, and every time to... every time to clean up from any constraints, abandon any kind of prejudice, and rethink with a very free mind, with a very free approach how the project should go. Just a few weeks ago, a great article appeared on New York Times, and I really like one expression that the journalist find out. It was this planet Urquiola. And I like because it's really, you know, in a way, in this way. When you start to work with her, when you start to talk with her, when you have, you know, the luck to get in touch with her, in a way, immediately, thanks to her energy, to this very contagious attitude, you feel immediately part of this fantastic planet.
Now it's your time. Fantastico. Ecco. Bueno, we had very good relation in the last period. Ecco, very strong. Ecco. Then I think it's very nice that Francesca is saying that. I think all the persons that are part of our metaphysical club, they are very, very interesting. Then that's not the point, I think. I'm part of it, and someone who has been really connected with the school, and then especially with Francesca, we share project, and it's been interesting for us, like for her, but for me too. Then today I'm gonna do, as all the other person from Metaphysical Club, just getting an approach to you. I'm telling a little bit about my work. No, I can do it in many ways. Francesca said to me, well, perhaps you can do this year, comunque, or this lesson, you can do it a little bit telling about the book you've done. I've done the book, they are 2 years and a half or something like this. Then the book was done. When you do introduce a book, you finish the book 1 year before. Then part of the work is a bit old. Like many things happened to me in the last time. Then we just introduce some images of things that happened to us, to the studio in the last period, but they are not absolutely all of them. But we wanted to keep the idea a little bit of the book, just to tell you the book. Then when I will do the next lesson, I will speak to you in another way, with another structure, speaking to you more about what is happening to me, especially now, okay? Then you will have two different approach to me. Then, I have this phrase, possibly, not so part of you is still having a lot of problems to understand Italiano, and then, but I think it's, for me, it's like a mantra. It's a mantra from Ettore Sozzas, one of the men of this, Italian and Milanese society that I choose in a moment of my life, ecco, to be my place
and that should be my place, and that's my place, and I'm living here for more than, well, it's 30 years, then it's a lot. I'm an old lady, then, but it's important that I, when I am speaking to young people and to students, ecco, and young professionists, ecco, that I'm, there is a long path I've done, because like this, I feel more comfortable to share it with you. If I was at the beginning of my path, perhaps I would say, no, no, I think there is no substance to tell anything. And now me, I'm still thinking that the path in life, more you live, is like when you like to travel or you like to read. The people that like really to travel or to read, when you say to them, "Have you? You did you travel a lot? Or did you, not so, have you ever, not so, there been many books in your life?" You say no, because you like to read or to travel. Then you understand anything you've done or you got the possibility to read, echo, it's been never enough, echo. Then me, I am in the middle of my path, or the beginning of my path. Then as you live your present situation, it's always very, it's fantastic, because even if you have me, I'm now 54 years old, I'm 54 years old. And in the way, if you are, if you live life, echo, as a, something that is a continuous evolution of your possibilities as a human being and as a projectista and as a designer or architect, as a mother, as everything, yeah, always, you know, quite beginning, echo, because there is a long path in front of you, and that is a sensation that is very interesting to always communicate to all of you. Me, I was in Milano when I was 22 years old, and but I was in Milano when I was 30 something, and I was already a little professionist, and I was in Milano when I was nearby 40 years old, and I was already divorced with all my life changed, and I was opening my real studio. And I am now, but they're still having the same sensation, and it's fantastic to give you that impression. But in the meanwhile, you do a lot of things. Many things happen, and that is what I can share with you. Un po' di calma is a bit of calm, of silence, of doubts, of curiosity, of questions that you do yourself, to ambiguity, to thought, to a little bit of thoughts, a bit of taking care of things, a little bit of solitude, of being aware, of, you know, so to, of this, you know, so force is who knows, no? At the moment, yeah, many moments you say, who knows tomorrow what I will do with that, or with that client, or with that project. Or a little bit of attention, or of help, a little bit of perplexity, a bit of sweet and, what is it? Amaro, bitter, sì, capito. Then, all these things, they are always nearby you when you are working and you are living as a progettista. I like to use the word progettista because it's very nice. In Italia, when you finish your studies, or as I finished my studies in Milano, I became a progettista. I didn't become an industrial designer or architect. I became both, ecco, because now, even in Politecnico, even in all those schools, ecco, you is more divided, ecco, the way you are more specialized. And me, I am still thinking, we are going to a world so complex. Me, as a creative working in relation with clients to do constructions, or clients to do industrial project, or clients to do that we have to do together an artisan product. In all these ways, for me it's the same, it's the progetto which is in the back, it's a project in my mind. Then I am a progettista, I'm not an architect or a designer or industrial designer. I'm all these things. I hope that you move the photo from what is intended is going to be your work to something nearby. Me, when I was young, I was thinking, till I was already 12 years old, and I was saying, I'm going to be architecto. And it's very good that I arrived to Milano and I became a designer and an architecto. And then I became a scenographer for a period. I became, many times, possibly when you come back and you're going to work, you know, so possibly your origin is, you know, so you come from China, and then you're going to be a fantastic professionist in London. I don't know what is going to be about your life. But things are going to change so many times. Then I think me, I always give the advice to move, echo, through those changes, and to understand your profession is a cultural profession, someone who has some skills, cultural skills that has to apply them to project. And the project can be many ways. Now I'm becoming art director. I always say it for a long time. No, no, art direction, no. I don't want. Then arrived a man from Mutina, a company that was very nice. He was doing tiles. The work was working very well. And then it was a little company. Then I became art director of that company. I said, the only one, because he's fantastic and I can manage that thing. But it's not truth. Now arrived to me that situation that I have, that they gave me this possibility to work in the whole group of Portonafrau and especially with Cassina. And something that two years ago I should say to you, no, I will not do it. I said, okay, they are now the circumstances to become projectista art director. And projectista art director means not to become an art director. When they give you something, and they ask you to do something, you always have to listen, to respect what they ask to you, but then you have to think by your own what means. That means for me, art direction for me is an old word, and I'm gonna try to change the meaning of that work and to make, you know, so after 5 years, I hope they will say, it's not anymore art director, it's como something else. Because I think the briefings that arrive to your life, they are always como a little cage. They are a structure, if you want, but they can be a cage too. Never a cage, always a structure. Then it's something, I don't know if I explained well to you, but for me it's very important to say that we begin to go. I'm gonna da 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 da. Ecco. Here we are. Bueno, this is from the Eames film, you know. But it's not important to speak about Eames and about. It's not exactly my only reference at all. But I always love the idea of, you know, an habitat can be for me. When they say to me, which is the room you prefer in your house, and I say, oh my God, how boring they are. The room in your house, Ecco. For me, which is the room I prefer? For me, a room is a carpet. In the grass, when you can be with someone, because for me, comunque room habitat is comunque a place. In some way, for me, it's a nest, but it's a place where you can share someone in a more intimate way, and where you can eat something, read, listen to music, and then that's comunque my concept of an habitat. Then, if I am architetto doing a hotel, I'm doing now the building, but I can do the interiors. For me, it's always my idea is thinking about my relations with other, what I think. It's not only my problem, it's I'm going to do a matching room, you know? Then I always think, I am in a carpet. This photo, they came from, was a Salone del Mobile. They were doing me a photo, blah, blah, blah. And they wanted to do me the photo in a certain way. I took the coat from the girl that was assistant of the photographer, and then I changed all the display, because they come with a briefing and I do the briefing by my own. I laid on my carpet. They wanted that it was for Vogue, because they were doing a special about design. And I said, give me all those plastic things. And I put my little armchair nearby, and then I did the photo as I think should be done. You know, then that's the attitude. That's very important for me to communicate for you, because I apply every day in my life, every day. Then I think to be a projectista in relation with a company or with a client is always to apply a kind of different point of view of the situation, trying to understand the heritage of the situation, understanding the problem, approaching really the problem, but always comunque giving, comunque, non so, experimenting the situation and rethinking always what they give to you. We are going to speak today about the book. That was a book that when I call it Time to Make a Book, not because I thought that now, that 3 years ago, was the moment to write a book, because no, the reason was that in that moment we were moving my family and my work family, which is the same, because me, I work now with 45 people, more or less. They are my family, because I share with them every day, all my day with the young people I'm working. But then I have my daughters, then it's part of my life. And then I live with my husband, Alberto, that works downstairs in the studio. And then when I come back home, he's still being there, you know? You know what I mean? Then my dog is always part of all of this. Then all these histories, Echo. At a certain moment, I had my studio here and my house there. And I said to Alberto, we have to put all together. We go inside a courtyard, we buy something inside, and we create a place where it's, you know, we are going to have a kind of sandwich, which is downstairs we work. Then in the middle we live. And if it's possible, I want a terrace. Like this, I have a garden, a kind of city garden. But a place that if I have to be working here and it's June or it's July or it's August and it's very hot and I'm suffering, I want to be there with my little plants and taking care of something. That was my need, no? Then we got it. And it's been, and then I said, I had to close everything and move. We all moved to a place all together. Then for me it was a moment, I closed a chapter of my life because we began something new. Then it was time to make a book. That was the reason of the name. And then if you see the image, which is, you know, cut it like this, when you get the book, they are not chapters, but they are sometimes dog ears in the book, very big, because they are two tribus of people in life. The people that when you give them something, a book, that they take care of it, then for them is, I'm not speaking about books with images, you know, big books, which is not the argument. I would say books for reading and for the little books you have in your life, all the books you have in your life. Those books, if you like them, I began to love books when I was a student. Then I was signing the things I liked. Sometimes with in another way, I was adding things and doing notes, doing dog ears, you know. Then when I still reading and I'm finding things I like, I sign, I do things on the book, Echo. And my husband doesn't do. Then many times we share books and he suffers my character because, oh no, I read it before you because then you destroy it, Echo. No? It's not true. Sometimes after years I take another a book that I read a long time ago and it's so nice to refined all the moments of emotion I had, Echo, reading the book. Then I said, when we're speaking in a graphical way, I said, I don't want to put any graphical Urquiola things inside. I only want to do, we signed the arguments with a dog ear because I do them. Then we did them very big, we did big ones, and it's the only real graphical sign which is in the book. And it's very autobiographical, something that I think is personal, no? As Mafalda, that I'm my Spanish roots, I'm then speaking Castellano. Echo Kino, which is comunque from South America, but comunque for all, I don't know in Italia, but in Spain was part, is like Asterix for the French people. Echo, Mafalda was saying, oh my God, Echo, why life begins at 40? When why they make us born so before, capito, so many years before? The problem is, and that is still, it tells a lot about me. My studio, when I got the coherence to be by my own and opening my real studio, I was 40 years old. You know what I say? With that, think about Echo, for you will be dramatic, no? And you say, no, I'm not gonna wait. Well, me, I did a long way. I learned a lot of things. I worked very well with people, with others. I didn't have this problem of ego. And I think it's good, because when things worked well and I was on the spot, I was already very protected. I have my jacket. It's not very important for me. I still been, and people that they know me for a long time, and you find the people that you work in your life. Now, for example, in Casina, I'm working with three persons. I met them in different moments of my life, and they know me, and the process is this. I still been, they're my roots. I got them in all that path. Then things don't change, doesn't change. And I think a designer has to be a very human and a mix of a human but very open person, very curious, that interact a lot with the company, understand a lot the problems, but is always, you know, a big fighter because you are an enfant terrible, you are moving always the limits of the company, but you are very inside, and they feel you very inside. If they feel you very inside, you do a good work. If not, it's much more complicated, the argument. And I remember that I'm part of this fantastic history of metaphysical club, and I think we share all together this idea of coherence and consistency. And for me, I still think a consistency is an argument. You have to move in a very open way and be very flexible to adapt always. But in that open, if you keep, you know, a certain attitude and a coherence in the back of all of it. That is the only coherence which is important for me. The other coherence for me, I move them completely every day. I think what we spoke the other day was very interesting. My coherence is my relation with, that is the hand of Zio Marino, the uncle of Patricia Moroso, the woman who gave me the credibility. Because it's always for the creatives, the problem is not what you are adding to your education and your possibilities to be a fantastic professionist that you want to become, or you are beginning to be, or you are beginning to become. The problem is, which are the people that can dialogue with you at the beginning? Which one believes in you at the beginning? That is very important, and Patricia was. And she had an uncle that was her mother's brother, the mother's brother, and he got a kind of depression in a moment. He was very sensible, and then he left the company, and then when he came back after a bit of therapy, he said, no, I am going to work only in the sector of where you do the prototyping, all the prototyping. I'm not going to work in the company, seriously. And then he became the master for all the meetings with all the designers. He's the one who does the first prototyping. Now he's a bit old and it's very complicated because sometimes he's a bit tired and it's not so easy to make him change ideas, and I fight a little bit with him. But there were days that we ended like this because we went, no, come on, we do more. And then his hand is like the, you know, anything we do and we put on the market, we have to think about our footprint. In our work as designers, it's our handprint. I always said, I like the metaphor of the handprint. The handprint is my problem because it's about what we think with hands. Everyday problem. And I like it. That was in the travel we were doing this summer in the desert in America. You know, I always look about, you know, all those passages, you know, that cabina de telefono, that old phone with this, you know, it was a very like an art piece, very interesting. A few years ago, Vico Magistretti, that was the man, I think I got a mentor in university that was Cacchile Castiglioni. And he was the man who made me focus on design. Okay. Then I helped him 2 years in university for all his lessons and for all the course of the project of industrial design. I worked with him and Bettinelli, Eugenio Bettinelli. And it was for me fantastic. But the real person that gave me a kind of imprinting was, I think, Vico Magistretti and Maddalena de Padova. I was working for E de Padova, Edizioni de Padova, and in that period it was a very essential company, with essential in everything, not only in the tools they were proposing to people, in the way they were running the company, because she was doing, she was thinking, she was always helping for a few people. Only, you know, always essential organization. No more people than necessary. Then they were essential in everything, in the way they were thinking. And that thing for me has been very important. And Vico was coming in the afternoon. He was living nearby. He was coming by in bicycle. And I tell you, in that period, in the end of 80s, the beginning of 90s, there were not so many people in bicycle. In Milano, it was flat as today. It didn't become more flat now. It was comunque. And then he was a man already like this. Then there were many little things that are to me, not only because, you know, the day that Vico said to me or the day we did a product. No, it was an everyday attitude and was for me incredible. The day they called me in Verona and they gave me the possibility of doing an exhibition about our work from the studio, and we did an immense work, and it was fantastic adventure. Vico died. He died, no, so 2 or 3 days before. It was the day that they did the funerale. I don't know how to say that in English. It's not important. And it was the day I was in the opening, and then I was going because I'm, you know, it's not so in this part of church argument, is not so interesting for me, but that day we come back, all of us, to the city, to, you know, to give honor to him in a religious way. And it was comunque, for me, incredible. It's like an angel. He became an angel. Like the day I had to show myself to the public. Then I said, sometimes things are very, not so, very emotional, no, very interesting. And I'm going back. That is, no, it's going on. We begin with the book, ecco. I'm thinking of something. No, it's okay. Ecco, in the book, I spoke with different person. But before doing the book, I did an interview with Gianluigi for Domus, not Domus Academy, for Domus Magazine, no, for the. And then we spoke about, it was about the books I like. I don't know if you want to read that interview, it's very interesting. It's about the books that were, no, so people, 8 books that have been important in your life, no? Then in that conversation we did, Michael, so there was something good in the air. We no, so was, you know, sometimes you get relations that you know that they are going to be important for something. And that was real. When I began to do my book, I said to Gianluigi, perhaps we can do an interview, you can help me to drive Echo part of the book, and then we're going to do a kind of write a test, and then we can do an interview. And then we didn't do one interview because he's a little bit like me. If you said to him, we do an interview, we did 7 interview, then what he said, no, you come with me to an event of Architectura, you come with me or something in Torino. We met in different situations and we did little pieces of interview, and then he did an interview of all these pieces together. Then we did the interview in a nice way, in the way I like it. Then in that thing, I understood he still, that it was the right person, because even in that thing, he was not, you know, so obvious. No, interview is done in a certain way. No, we invented a different way on the stage. We did a micro interviews all together. And then this is part of the book where is the interview with him. That was one of those moments, the little photo, one of the moments of our conversations that I like it to have it there. And then when he spoke about, we spoke about stupid things, because the interview is not too much about, you know, my work. At the end we are speaking, there's a moment where I'm telling him about an image I have in my mind about Australia. I traveled a few times to Australia, and there was one moment that I was speaking with one agent of Moroso. And we were traveling, and in Australia sometimes you go from one place to another place, you go by plane tendentially. But in that case we were in by car, and you know, was that strange space for me. It was a curious place. And he was telling me, you can imagine, one time I was going from Melbourne to I don't know where, and there was a sunny moment, and there was a light, come si dice, un poste, un, non so, a beam, capito, ecco, for the light. And there was a family, and there was the shadow of it, very like a stripe. And there was a family of kangaroos, capito, all them in the back, in the stripe, ecco, you know. And that image, I think we were speaking in the, we were speaking about, you know, in that way, in a very metaphorical way. And something that I think, what is happening in this school, like, is very important. And that's how Gianluigi runs a conversation, and that's the way I get very involved in a conversation. No, then the kangaroos. I think one day, if my profession changed to another professions, and we can, I can tell histories with other mediums, like, and it's something I have always here. Perhaps I will never do, but I. More than they say, one day I will like to paint. You know, I think I will like to do some mystery, some narrations. Get a narrative with as a filmmaker, Echo. And I have to find the right friends, Echo, or the right I don't know what. Like, I mean, but one of the images that is gonna be this. Another one was I was traveling with Alberto and Sofia this summer through deserts. I love deserts, eh? And it was so hot. After a few days, was, you know, so 12 years we were traveling. We arrived to Phoenix, and then after one day there, we went to see some things of architecture, blah blah, and then we went to the hotel, very classical, done by the assistants of Frank Lloyd Wright, and we said, well, we have a brunch, we do a bath in the pool because it was really really hot, and we have a look of the place, and we get inside the place, and something was strong in the place. I couldn't understand, something was wrong, and it was moving. We arrived to the pool, and I understood. Everybody in this classical hotel, they were all tattoos, full body tattoos. Everybody in the pool then was more obvious because people, we were seeing all the naked body. And it was incredible. I said, if I begin a new profession in my life, that's going to be the first image, not the kangaroo. I changed it. I come to this one. Because to see that place, that was called the Frank Lloyd Wright, a space where you go as an architect and you go with a file in your mind and you get that thing. I said, Alberto, here's something happening because Phoenix is so advanced or something is strange here. There was a congreso. It was a 3 days tattoo congress in the hotel. Then they were doing they were the 200 more important tattooers of America doing tattoos to people who come crazy for tattoos that they do the whole body in an incredible way. And they were all then having a bath in the pool. Then I couldn't do the pool bath because I was with me without tattoos, that is ridiculous. I can't use that pool because I'm not fitting well. But I was in love and I didn't do photos because I was feeling, you know. But I say, I know that in this period of the summer, you can go there. Then we can, if I one day I begin doing those histories, then if I change my path, you know, it's what I want, it's always about that. Me, I never think, you know, the path is something that hasn't have to evolve. That's very important because then I don't think what I'm getting is so important. That I want to say to you is very important. I think is the only way to be not so fresh in our profession. It's the only thing I will say to my daughter, Seco. Then, here is my conversation with him. That is a photo that I always like a lot because it's a little bit telling me arriving very young to Milano. Here there is Castiglioni, Echo, the man. He was doing, I had Elvis Costello record, and he got one, I don't remember the name, but he's here like this with it. And there's an image from Elvis Costello that is from my generation, I think one of the incredible minds and in music, and he was with a photo like Elvis Costello. Then, you know, there is nothing is alone. And then there is Wim Wenders. There are a few films of Wim Wenders that have been very important for me in my generation because this idea of traveling, of moving the path. Obviously, we come back to the same argument. Or, for example, La Notte from Antonioni. This film is fixed in my mind. It's fixed. Today, I was with a client. He told me he wanted to do a party. It's from fashion. It's an history. And he wanted to do a party after, 12 years or 15 years of his company, blah, blah. And he's Milanese. And I said, I know what we're going to do. We are going to reproduce one moment of La Notte, and we are going to do, we will come back to this history. This history was about this industrial, it all happened in a night in this phantomatic villa from Industriale, you know, those big industrialists from Milano. Milano was representing the industria. And everything happened in that party, in that. It's a very interesting film. If you didn't see it, have a look because it's. It's about incommunication. It's a very interesting film. Then for me, it's in my back, in the back of my mind every day. We did a lot of work from in the last 14 or 15 years, a lot of work. Possibly me, I accumulate a lot of energy working with others. And then for me, it was very easy to run and come with things because there was a lot on. Sometimes in life, there are periods that you. Perhaps you don't produce a lot, but you accumulate things. Other periods when you came out, it's very interesting. It's not important. And I think when you see the whole life of someone, that's very important to understand that they've been very productive in a period. Other periods they were absorbing. The timing in your life is very important for me. And this is, that's another thing that I don't want to tell you now because I told many times today I don't want. Here we have the hand, and then this Patricia Moroso. These are prototypes, ecco, from her, just to tell. She drived me in the possibility of feeling as a designer. She was producing only cities. Her company especially does more or less place for sitting, then some complements too. Then my credibility was on that. Bit by bit, ecco, all the companies arrived to me and people asking me to do all the typologies, because sometimes, you know, someone begins doing light and perhaps he's very sensible doing other typologies and people don't understand because you have to get the credibility. Then it's an argument that is going to be part of your life. Ecco, you will remember what I say to you, because that's another part of the path, very important. You don't have to leave anyone put your label on you. Ecco, never, never, never find a way. Never, because the labels are terrifying, you know. You are person sensible, open, and you are evolving, then nobody can say what you are. You are till today, and nothing else. Time to Make a Book was part of the book. This was the beginning of the book, and it's my homage to Vico Magistretti. It's the Selene plastic chair that many times, you know, so if I was, I bought it in a, so in a market or something like this, you know, when you get things which are easy. I'm not someone who is getting important pieces of furniture, and I'm not a collector, but if I am in a little market or thinking in a travel, I can get things in an easy way. Then I destroy them. Then it's the contrary of a collector. I think collectors are very important because they take care of our work. And then they many times in a maniacal way, but they are fantastic. Me, I'm the contrary. Even today, something from my house came down and we destroyed it. And I know my daughter's going to say, what is happening with this? This is happening many times to me. Then we took the Selene, and me, normally when I go in a taxi, if I see that kind of, you know, overseat, I always say, why you are using this? It's because you use it for not so because you get a bit sweat and then you need it, or you use it because it's ergonomical, and I do a lot of inquiries, when I find this thing. Then it's an element that the guys in the studio, they got for me, because, you know, and then they were living perfectly. Then it was a kind of manto, a dress for a protection for Vico. Then I did a kind of ready-made. Sometimes ready-made, they have to be very connected. They have to tell something of your idea. It was a kind of, a message of, you know, protecting what is the heritage I have from him. The way you do it is always personal, no? Vico was the day that we had a Vico when we opened the exhibition. The exhibition, they were micro prototypes, things. Was incredible, the quantity of things we had inside. And here, you know, there were macro things, micro things, many, many histories, and it was very interesting for us. I don't know if it's working, this. I have to touch it and it's going to work. At the end of the exhibition, the thing that got in my mind and is the essence of the exhibition is not working? Bueno, it's not important. There were the shadows of this dry cleaning rail that was with part of my prototypes. The shadows on the wall was the most interesting thing of my exhibition, and it's the thing that I keep in my mind. As you know, in the Angar Bicocca, if you see the work of Parenot, a Capito Fantastico, he's using different technologies, and then there's an overlaying of, you know, the lighting, the video, and then the shadows. Me, I was the other day saying, I said, why, fantastic exhibition. I don't know if all of you've been, but you have to go now. It's from, I do now, Angar Bicocca is open from Giovedì, Wednesday, no, Thursday to Sunday until 11. You have to go. If anyone didn't go there, has to go even today. Because it's, you know, when artists, they are working in with technologies in a so easy way and so domestic, and there's no limits for them. As he's working in this moment, it's a big honor for all of us to have him in Milano. Bueno, here's the studio, was the old studio. We were working very well. The space was the same as the one I have now. Then the problem was not a question of a space, it was putting together my house and my studio. Many times I was working, this was in a trouble, and with my clients, I was all the time inside a showroom, and I said to them, basta showroom, I can't afford. Then I have to be with you here, have 2 days, I have a bit of jet lag, and we said, I want to go to the desert, now let's go. And then we were not doing a picnic, we were doing the meeting. Then we did all the you remember the other day of a metaphysical club, we went to the garden, the one was with me. Me, I always have moments of claustrophobia. Then even the place, when I came here, the first 2 years I was doing some lessons, I never wanted to be in the place. I went outside, we use it. It's a kind of exercise I need to do just to say, you give me this, I move to there. Echo. That is important. I don't know if it's good or bad. The psychoanalyst will work on this. But I think possibly it's always trying to say, move the point of view. Move the point of view, and then things, they get another value. That's the studio. Sometimes we work, sometimes we have our 3D machines, 3D printing machines. We are doing prototyping, we work, we do a lot of things all together. And my architects, sometimes they get involved in process of design. My designers, they get involved in the process of the architecture. I try that we are all connected. And this is one of the arguments. Circle line was an argument interesting in the book. The idea was thinking about those items that they got, in some way in my mind. When I was little, there was a chair, a compact chair, from a Swedish chair, that we had two, they were in wood, then they became white, because my mother painted them in white, things which are wood in home, and they are not very important, you change them the color, no? They like this, they live longer. Then for a long time I wanted to do this typology because it became very rustic. Then I said, we have to work on this, and then we did with Cartel, this chair, and I like it a lot. The process was long chair. Then in the same period, a lot of young people, they were working on those kind of typologies. Then I think it's been something very... I like this project. It was represent a lot something that I wanted to do in a moment where it was not really on the mood and became part of the mood of many, on the community of designers. Then I appreciated. This was a bathtub. I was doing a project of architecture. It was a hotel in Caribbean. Then working for W Group, American company, and they were asking me for many things, but they said, no, in the all the suites, you have to put absolutely a bathtub, which is important bathtub. I said, bathtub? You are with flip-flops and you are with sand. I'm going to put a kind of... we're going to work in another way. We're going to move completely the project. And the bathtub, I don't need a bathtub. I want to have a kind of tin echo. Then nobody listened to me for 2 years. And even normally they were doing some things in Puerto Rico, nearby, other parts in the island, other parts in Miami. And even some parts they were coming from Asia. But nobody wanted to do my bathtub. And then I was complaining with my client Agape. I said, I do it for you. And then he did the prototypes and then became one of the items that represent Agape, this Italian company that do bathrooms and things. And the prototypes are in the hotel, and then became Vieques, the name of the hotel and the island, became the then a project of architecture that was 3 years project, gave the door for beginning a project of design. That was quite important. If I was a normal architect, I will never have done this. I should finish the problem, a tab, and so with bubbles, because the clients are impossible many times. But I went on, and it was so boring. This, I am boring, and those things. And I found an Italian that at the end of the process, inserted the bathtub, and then they became a product, and now is having this bath is having... A production and longer life than the hotel. Then from a need of architecture became a process of design. Then that thing happened many times in life. You want to be in an apartment and you finish in another thing. You want to be in London and then you finish in a little town nearby Paris. But get the process in that place. Get on the energy on what you get. At the end, for me, never big goals. I think big goals is a man's word that I still think in. That's not my word. I think it's not thinking in little. No, that not. We are people that we are trying in life to get things bigger than you. Then you have a lot of ambitions, but nice ambitions. But big goals, many times they are too much connected with big ambitions. I think ambitions is an attitude of getting more than what you are, bigger than you. But goals can be terrifying, because if you get them, you get, you know, they are not any more interesting. If you don't get them, you get a little bit frustrated. It's much better to move and then let, you are with a good compass, you think things, you drive in directions that you believe, but then let things that arrive to you, that they give you, if they are interesting, get on them. You have to create always, change comunque the dimension of the focus, not only big goals. I think goals have to be something much more interactive. I think will be an argument very interesting to speak in a kind of metaphysical club. Because I think the capitalistic world we live in, the world of exchange, the commercial and communicative world we live in, is having a big change. I think the argument is another one, is how to move the value of gold cycle. Something that would be speaking 1 hour. I'm going to run. This is a little drawing from Sofia, my little daughter. I was doing the prototyping and she was seen, and she's always coming to the studio. She comes continuously to the studio. And then she got and she's doing drawing. And then I love it that she did a drawing of the chair. And then that was the product. This was another product done with, it's not important, the company. This is more also, but this, I like it because I was saying to them, we are going to do a Chester, the only artisan place for sitting or sofa sitting, which is still being very proud of being so artisan, is the Chester typology. And I say, ay, basta. No, we are going to do a Chester, which is done like a jacket with, how do you say, press button? With a clip, no, not clips, with a, how do you say? Buttons. Si, but the automatic, no? How do you say? Not with magnet, complicated you are. No. This one, like a capito. These are the normal ones, capito. Then I said, we are going to create a mold which is recreating in some way a kind of landscape. Correct for it. And then we are going to work and we are going to use this press button, and we use for two different companies. Then they were not working so well. Like this was working perfectly, the project. Then we did a kind of thought in an industrial way, but looking with as something that would be classical. And then just always changing in that case for me was the limit to move was the prejudice of being too much artisan in a company. Possibly you can keep a mood of something very well done in a certain way, but you can play the game in another way. Then I was all the time speaking to them, Zio Marino, we have to do like a Moncler with the press button. You know? And it was very complicated to, this little thing, it's been long to make the company understand, because they were saying, it's impossible. There are a lot of impossibles in your life. This was a company that they called me Emu, and they invited me to visit. It's very important when you visit a company first times, because you go them with, they invite you because they want you to do a kind of project. And then you go to the company to understand the technologies. But when you see the technologies, you see many other things. You see even the things that they have, you know, in the back of. And in the back of the place, they were showing to me all the robots, because they had a quite good technology, and that was the good thing they thought could offer to me. They have an archive of the old chairs they were doing in the company, and they were all, you know, those old garden chairs with very artisan. Each chair was done of 40 pieces different, nothing to do with what they wanted from me. And I said, the sample chair you're asking to me, I'm not interested. I'm going to... I had the drawing, I had already a little prototype. I forgot it. I said, basta, I'm not interested in that. I want to work with a kind of review. We're going to rethink all the archive you have, and you don't think it's important, but for me it's important. And we're going to do, with the robot, we are going to do a losange. And the losange, we're going to do it many times. And it's going to be one losange is going to reproduce the concept of all the old chairs you were doing for garden. Then. These playful things became fantastic. Then we were using the robot. Many things happened in the process. And it's not. I never worked with them. I didn't work with them after this project, because they changed the management. The managers came, changed it, and I didn't like what they did. then I didn't have the relation with the right person, then I said, basta, I got frozen. This is me, eh? Ecco, I'm very open, and then I close, and you communicative? No, I'm not communicative. And many people said to me, why didn't you work anymore with, because I think the person I spoke, that was interesting, I was, went away, then the company, I'm not interested. I could not, I'm not any more interested. Then another thing that we have to know, when to finish a relation. Because they are, you have to understand why to get on relation with someone. It's very important because possibly the first project you do doesn't come perfect because we are not perfect. We are projectistas. We are plenty of energy and we believe in what we think and we have a cultural attitude. But it doesn't mean that me, when I arrive to a company, perhaps the project I do with the company, which is good, is the third. Then why to keep on relation with someone that you didn't get the best perhaps in the first relation? You have to understand, it has to do a lot with how is the relation with the human beings in that company, how you can use a kind of empathy, how can be a real empathy applied to your work. That's an important argument. That was it's funny because it's from that chair in that period I was upset with Los Angeles. Then we worked in little dimension for a company, and then we did those lighting for the city in Christmas time, and they should be comunque with they should be done in another way. I was not very happy about the work in the city because of other reasons. But bueno, all that history I vomited. It came out, and I'm not working anymore in that thing. That argument of Los Angeles is far away of my mind now. That's another project, very simple. You know, is technology easy? But the way we produce this technical part of the chair normally was done in a very artisan way. We do it with machines, with 3D acts. Then it's nice how to do. You go to a company, this is a Spanish company, and the company has a machine that they don't know how to use, or they have it because they bought, you know, at the end of the year some machines, but they are there, and they don't use the control numeric, or they are not. And it's important that you are the person that refreshes that attitude. Now, I don't think it's here because it's not part of the book, and I don't think if you. I did a work with. I'm looking to Lucrecia because I don't think I was asking to her to add things that we have done the last years. I worked with Listone Giordano, an Italian company that does parquet, the flooring. There is inside? Okay, we will see it. And then I will speak about this later. Then I will tell you. Bueno, that's a work of architecture. The client, I did a hotel in Berlino. It's not important to speak about the whole hotel, but there was two stars Michelin chef, and they wanted that the important restaurant. There were two restaurants in the hotel. The important one, they wanted to put it in the more important place of the hotel. I said, no. We put the normal restaurant in that place because there is daylight, and everybody can go from the breakfast, and perhaps they don't have money to spend for having a dinner as expensive as this, and they can be one night. We use this for anyone that can go to the hotel. And the restaurant, the expensive restaurant, we put it nearby the kitchen. In that space that was absolutely dark, and my clients from Germany would say, no, it's impossible. And a lot of conversations and we did it. You know, the kitchen is connected in all the halls with this space, which you are not in the kitchen because there were a lot of, but you are in that space. Then if you want to eat in that way, you go there. If not, you can go in the other part of the hotel. Those fights for me are very important because in the whole of a project in architectura, there must be a few things that they have some aim, no? They have your soul, and it's not only because you have an idea of using materials or because it's something more than that. It's because you have some concepts that they arrive to your clients strongly, to the stomach of them, that's an important thing. That is, speaking about kitchen, I worked for 3 years with Bofi, and we are defending now all around the world the collection. It's a sophisticated and very high-level company, but it was an occasion to investigate about materials. We are using Komukum. It's a kitchen which all the boxes that they create the kitchen, normally any kitchen you get from IKEA to high-level, the inside they are made in melaminic, Komukum, the box inside, you are doing the dress. And you do fantastic tops, you can do many things, but at the end, and I said to them, I'm not going to do a dress kitchen, I'm not going to do. You do already very well, fantastic people working with you. I'm get bored. I want to do a kitchen with cheese. We do a frame, very simple in metal, and we find a way to get only comunque very thin elements to close it and no boxes inside. If it's not going to be an adapted, it's not going to be a kitchen that you can adapt from wall to wall. You have to use it in a modular way. Then we are going to lose part of your clients because, you know, the big of the, when you work in this level of kitchens, the clients, they need to adapt perfectly because they are spending a lot of money. That my kitchen has less possibilities because it's modular. But I said, it's okay, it's the same. Even if it's not business for me, I'm going to work like this. And I think the sign that we gave with this kitchen, which is modular and it's not adaptable, is making the company rethink the way they propose themselves with the clients. And is creating a certain passage that I'm very, the thing I'm more proud of this work, is that. Not about only that. Then it's what I think I like to say to you. Craft time. Bueno, I've been working a lot in crafting. Those little images about thing. I did an exhibition about 2006, I think. Something like this, in Germany, in Colonia, in the fair of Cologne, and I was pregnant of my little daughter. I didn't know, because it was I knew when I come back from Germany, and there was Hella Jungerius, this fantastic lady, doing the other Idle House. There were two ladies in Confronto, and she had a baby in that moment. With all these hormones on the body, a lot of antibodies running. And I think there were two works very interesting and very crafted both. And it was very interesting because to speak about craft today is very normal, but in 2006, and it's not so far away, was an argument strange. Me, I was intended a designer working in industria, working with very good Italian industrials in a certain way, but not too much crafting, because all my work for outdoor and like this was not coming already. In that period, I only have done the work for Driade, then know all the other things that came later. Then me, I asked to all my clients to do items, but we dress it and we finish unfinished. All the products were modified or unfinished. Then I was not putting my items to do a kind of manifesto. Everything was half off or changed. And outside, I didn't ask to do a kind of architecture. I just rented a scaffolding, which is a metal frame, you know, the one that they use for rebuilding, when they are changing a building, then they put the scaffolding, you rent it, and then the net that we use inside, the white net you said, is the net for scaffolding. We did a canvas, and we did very delicate things on the canvas. Then we used stripes outside, and it was very light. It was something when they did it, and we dismantled. It was an easy thing. We reused all the red stripes. We used part of the things. We just give back. We gave back the scaffolding. Then for me, it was an exercise to understand what means for me, comunque, how you use the things when you're telling your house. Are you comunque for a fair that is for 1 week? How you have to manage all these problems? There was a moment that I was beginning to think a lot about my attitude with a sustainable, more open mind, not only comunque how to recycle things, how to reuse, how to get in relation with many things in different levels. And many of my friends, industrial designers that were coming there, they said, oh, but that thing from B&B is half of it, or you finish with this dress. And I didn't have many words to explain myself, because at that moment I was doing things with my stomach. I was going through industrial and craft attitude, crossing them. And when you begin something, you have instinct, very strong. Then after 1-2 years, I was saying, obviously, I was doing a path in between a research in industrial way and a research of what is for me a craft attitude. Then was things that was different. I think many times when you are creative, or you are, I think happened a lot to many creative people, and artists is more than evident, capito, that you know that's what you have to do. Then perhaps many words are not so important. Some of my friends came inside and understood immediately. That was the only element, the only project I've done in that period that was a product crafted from Urquiola. Then people, they were asking for me for other things. They were not understanding very well what was in my mind. No, that was interesting, the relation. I connect that with this product that came after, that I began to get in this world, and I love it that Gillo Dorfles went to the Salone del Mobile and he did the photo very happy on that chair. He was my Emmanuel, you know? Then Gillo Dorfles in that chair from Driade for me is like the manifesto of Emmanuel. It's exactly the same thing in my mind. Or you see it here, Sisi. I live nearby Piazza del Risorgimento, where Sisi is a place where you can have a coffee or a lovely croissant. But I know the couple, they have, and I know them till they opened the place when they was not very known in the city. And I always go, I do photos with them. This is a relation. Then I love that he's... the girl, she's Italian, he's African, and he loved to do the photo with my chair because becoming a bit African. Then all these sisters are part of my mind. In that period, I began to do with Paola Lenti, the mother of Paola Lenti. In a day, we were speaking a possibility of working me with Paola and her brother and her sister. The mother came there, and we were speaking about things done by hand, and she said, "Oh, me, I'm very good in crochet." The mother said. And she went away. And then, 2 days after, I called Paola and said, "Paola, we are going to do the prototype of this. We asked you to your mother. Perhaps she can help us." And the mother did the prototyping of that carpet. Then that's, and then because Paola didn't have any industrial machine for doing that project. Then this project is absolutely artisanal in a company that wanted from me an industrial thing. Then why not? This was like this. Then we didn't work more together because I said to Paola, "I think, Paola, you're doing so well that to put another woman inside in project is complicated. I think you have to work by your own, and me, I have to do my work." And I think I did something good. There was too much creativity altogether. She didn't need me, and I think I gave her good advice. I'm not very interested when I get a new relation to keep it because of nothing. You get, you leave, and you understand what you have to do, and you move the relation continuously, every day, is what I think. Here was in the contrary, I was working in B&B, finally doing my sofa, then I was getting Comunque the product you want to do with that company, because they do the foam, industrial foam, inside the company. Then it's a honor for a designer to work with them in sofas. They don't give that possibility to many. Normally they ask you to do a table or something else, because there is Antonio Citterio doing them. Then it's not easy to get the skills to be the other one doing the sofas for them. And I began to do them in that period. Then Giorgio came to me, which is the son, was the owner of the company, and said to me, "Patricia, we have a division of outdoor, and now Antonio cannot do it because he's doing a work with I don't know what kind of company. Then could you help us? We have to introduce it for September, and it was June." I said, "It's June for September. Me, I have to do a division in outdoor, and then you have to do it in Filipinas, and how we manage this." "Oh no, but you are good, come on." Then I was in good mood in that period, and then I did one, two ideas, and I said to him, "Well, if you want something, I have to go to Philippines, and I have to be there to do a kind of workshop with the people there, and if something comes out, we present in September." Then they said to me, yes, they sent me with one of the family, and my husband, and we've been there with a hot, I can tell you. And they put me in a room with air conditioner. After half an hour, I said, "I can't be here, I'm gonna be there." Then I put a Bermuda, and I've been 1 week there. Then my husband and the one of B&B, they came outside, them too. And we did a kind of workshop, and we came out three collections, Then that means, if you want to work in a place, and in that case was more handmade attitude, then you go there, you get the energy of the people, you understand the values of the people working with you. Then the first 3 days I was asking, "Anything you do in home, take it here. I want to see what is for you comfortable. How you work in this, if we do this, you are working better for doing this." for me, it's very important if you're using a machine to understand how you can make the machine work in a better way, or to use it in a way that you didn't use till now. If you're working with something which is more crafted, how to change the rules, or how to do it more affordable or more sustainable, the process. Not just sending things and someone is going to do because it's perhaps it's less expensive or this miracle. That's not the argument. Like, the argument is absolutely another thing. Then we didn't have a place there to see our things. Then we did that thing. We put a paper, and then anything we were doing the night, we were putting there. And then every day was growing and growing all our product. At the end, if it was there one month, we should have done a company, like a bit. Like, no, but really. And at the end, they were sending emails from B&B saying, please say to Urquiola, we don't need any more. We don't, because he would. And I said, they are ridiculous, like a bit. Well, that was, Pirelli asked me to do a research. At the end, they didn't use it because they were, you know, at the end, they didn't have the money for doing that exhibition. A very easy thing, very, very nice history. But in my mind, there was this black tube of, that I wanted to do something, but I couldn't do. Then I called Patricia and I said, Patricia Moroso, now we're going to use that element. It's going to be a rope very strong and we are going to create that thing. That's a product that now I've saw a lot of other families of products collected with this, but I'm very happy of that history. Or for example, in that period, I was working with Ketal, because a few companies arrived to me. You know, she can do these things, we can work with her. And I did a carpet. That carpet, everybody was saying to me, they are in 3D, and they are como woven in a very dense way. Oh, those are really crafted. They're so interesting from your work. And Amia was making fun. These are made in it with a machine that they founded in Torino, which is absolutely industrial, done for doing meshes in metal. Then when you use plastic, because they gave me the only machine they had, which is a little bit out of, you know, so not working so well, the old one. We bought it, and then we use it, and the way that comes out, the weaved argument, is looking like very crafted, but it's absolutely industrial. Then it's very interesting to understand what means the possibilities of how to use something in a way which is, if you are crafting, but you are working in a, how to melt in your relations many of those arguments. It's not important. I think you understood already. That is, for example, another history. I'm working now in Singapore. I'm doing other crossovers with other architects. I think that I hope in my future, in my life, I'm gonna can tell to anyone I've been doing this work, not me there, Patricia Studio with that studio from Melbourne. I could come here, I will come here and I will say you, I'm doing that work with that studio because we are sharing knowledge. They are working in that part, me I'm working. That thing is something I think in the future, I think is, so it's part of things I did, of my desires, of my goals. Then my goals are more or less like this. In that case, we are sharing with a studio from Singapore. They have this structure. It's a building which is using the possibilities of not using too much air conditioner, using different types of ways of moving the air, is more sustainable and has a double skin, the building, this red skin, is there is a gap in between the windows of the building and this skin, and there are plants in the middle, and then the whole of it is going to be like a micro architecture, a micro, quasi micro city, because more you are in a higher level, we are melting plants, they are big gardens, you know, the reception of the hotel is at a quite high level, and then you arrive and it's quite in an open air. Because I said, when you think about Singapore, you think about the Raffles Hotel, you remember those gardens with, you know, the Pai Pai, people sitting there, and then you arrive to Singapore now and you are all in those buildings in the back of glass. We have to come back, we have many instruments and technologies to melt and to give to people, good values, but I think in a new way. No, then I think that was the argument. And I don't know if it's gonna come nice or bad. And me, I'm doing the hotel inside, but we are melting a lot of know-how, like a bit, and it's very, very interesting. There's a Japanese girl working in the garden, which is coming from Japan. The other one from Singapore, us from Italia. Well, that is the concept. And it's going to be finished, I think, for January, February. Then the next time I'm going to go there. I have one of my studio living there already. He's an Argentino guy, became a Singaporean. Molto bello. I love that thing. He, from the south of here. I said to him, you're going to say to me one day, thanks, because he was a bit afraid to be so far away, taking care of, at the end of the project, him, Echo, and the other ones, we come up and down, but we need one there. And it's very nice. We have another guy, a Chinese guy from Singapore, very nice working with him. Bueno, that is part. You know, he sent me photos like this, Echo. Those are photos of the work, but continuously, it's very interesting. Perhaps sometimes I'm going to run. I like this image. You know this image was running in the... It's not from... perhaps you know well. But I love this art. Echo, that's a moment. Don't worry. That's part of, became an always a young girl, even if you are 54 years old. That's the formula. I love the concept of this thing. The idea of, you use these machines, no? Echo. How someone can approach a machine like this and use it in another way. You can go over the problems in many ways, in a very easy way. Then here's a demonstration of, there are no limits in approaching Echo. Many circumstances we have. Go avanti, capito, because now it's not going to work anymore, no? Oh, fantastico. Bueno, yeah, keep with me that I like you to be near by me. Echo. This is, for example, they called me from Biennale di Venezia, and they said to me, me doing industrial product in another way and being an architect, they said to me, we need you that you do for the next Biennale. It was the Art Biennale, not Architectural Biennale. Then I said, why Biennale? You do with maestros, you have to come 6 times here in the matinee, work 6 hours because they are very expensive, and you can do a collection for the next Biennale, it's going to be part. I said, I am not a specialist in glass, and normally if someone doesn't know about this can do something awful. Are you sure? But at the end we did it, went to Art Basel, and the history was interesting. It's not important to tell you all the history, but at the end of the world, if you see here, you see the maestro, Echo, Andrea, he was lovely, and he was all the time with those hands in his hands, here you have it, and he was all the time putting them in water and saying to me, how I do? I say, no, less. Because my drawings were not interesting for him. Anything was interesting because he's working with fire. And he's like, if you are doing jazz, you can play very well the piano. And then the moment say, no, don't come the partitura out. You listen to all of us and you run with us, Echo. Then that was the argument. Then he was saying to me, take here, and I was changing. We were doing all in the moment, Echo, in the moment. And each hour in my mind I knew was very expensive. Then it was a very complex situation because you have to be brave, but you have to be calm. Then at the end of the workshop with this fantastic man, I did a vase with his hands, Echo Capito. That was the protection he had in his... And this vase is the memory of all that experience I had. Because this hand, I did them in glass, and in that vase, I want to have one day one, because you do important things they never give to you. But I think that one is the at the end of a relation with someone like this, what I got. We worked with BMW for a concept car, but now we keep it in contact, and for a triennial, they want that I get always doing some lectures for them and doing some projects for them. Then it's been very nice relation. There should be only a work for 3 months and became a relation. Then sometimes that is a honor. Then I'm very proud of this relation with them. They asked me, they were introducing in a Salone del Mobile a Berlina, I hate cars. Then they said, are you sure you want me for this? Because me, I don't like cars, then possibly I'm not the right person. They said to me, no, we want you because not liking cars, you are going to work on the car with another point of view. Then I said, yeah, but even if I cover the car, you leave me do it? Yes, we leave you. Then we did a kind of architecture. I covered the car. You couldn't see the car. But we create those prostheses, the yellow prostheses that were fantastic on the prototype. And then we worked with all the system of items you need for traveling. It was very conceptual. We were thinking about what you need. They are doing a lot of research on the leather they use. They are going to use even, I think, you know, so skin leather one day. But they're still not thinking about, you know, if I am traveling in a Berliner with you in a long travel, if I want to take a rest, at the end is with my jacket. Why there is not something that is adaptive? And why they are not thinking about the pockets? Why they are not thinking about the lighting? Then it was very interesting. It was nice work. But from that car, I go to another car. This was the only, we did an exhibition in Triennale, and came out, comunque, the need. Mia was doing the architecture for this exhibition about time, and working with more or less 100 designer and artist. And at a certain moment, I said, but we are speaking about time, and we are doing all this research of projects to tell in this exhibition, but there is no time machine. Why an exhibition about time without a time machine? That's a disaster. Then we were asking for, and we didn't find any work. Then we said, I'm going to do it. Then a time machine for me was an exercise of concentration, like a Zen exercise. I know a Marina Abramović, and we were speaking about this machine, and it was a honor that she appreciated this conversation, because she's doing now a kind of new museum where you can go and you can be 6 hours minimum, and they give you an action to do, and you get concentrated on that action, and then you have in a time, you give all your aim to that thing, and then after the end of that lapse of time, your mind is in another situation. Then, for me, this exercise was more or less the same. I went to Moroz and I said, okay, we are not going to work for production. We are going to take all items of things I've done. We are going to put all them together. We are going to create a kind of time machine. It's the only machine that doesn't work. If you remember, it's the only one that is still being part of fantasy or of the, you know. It's the only machine, as Bruno Munari will love it, because it's, love it, the concept. I don't say the car, like my car. I say the, because he was a big lover of machines that doesn't work. Still being one of the only things we, you know, the teletransporto to move in the time and in the, we still been a problem for all of us. Then we created a kind of this bag connected with films and things. It was an history, very nice. But we did it in 15 days. Working 13 hours for that, and I was putting the things with them. Nobody was asking why, and we didn't know what we should get. But we were doing, you know, in a sacred way. And came out, it's working, it's in museum, and something is very happy. That was the way we have done it. Perhaps you can... ecco, espera, scusami. It's not important I show you many things. Important is to understand what I think, Echo. Then we prepare this thing. They say, okay, Mia was saying, well, we are going to use those items. We are going to get, you know, all the fantastic scientific films. One is The Fly, which is Kubunke. All the Japanese, there is Time Bakam, which is a very important manga, which is connected with the time machine. Then we put all the things together, all those things. They were the eyes of our element. And then all of them, they were the papa, the mother, the technicians, they were working with me for something they knew was not for production. It was an exercise of, you know, of concentration. That was, what was it? Even for me, I was losing a lot of time. My company, so the studio was calling all the time to me, oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? I said, no, I don't want to listen to anyone. Then sometimes it's very important to stop things. That was part of the elements we were using. That's a work we've done in India. The people that were doing for me the prototype, and I was asking how they could work, they said to me, the shapes is not our best thing. If you do a very clean product, we have problems. Try to use the energy. Then I use all the energies, and I did a very playful element just to create a path in relation with them. They didn't have a place to show me continuously photos about the prototyping, and I said, you go on the ceiling of the roof of the company, and then you hang them, and And then I saw every week the prototyping. Then is the you always have a way to show things in a good way. Ecco. This is, for example, in a work three-dimensional connected with a set of copies of Monari, to something that I liked a lot, and we did with Glass Italia, this research. We are doing now a new research with them, which is, it's not here, I don't know if they are here. Pero ¿dónde están? Al final del todo. Es un rollo. Bueno, no problem. Perfecto. Ecco, here you see comunque, this was a chair, antibody, and from that chair I took the frame and it became the Tropicalia, as you have here. Then sometimes from a product to another one. That was a work done in Turkey. In Istanbul, my clients, they were asking me, they were, you know, tools for the kitchen, appliances and blah, blah. But the way we were introducing the concept and acting about it was very interesting, the process with them. Synthesis. This was a chapter dedicated to elements or histories of the studio that were very clear from the beginning. In this case, me, I dedicate even to Vico this chair, because he was always saying to Maddalena de Padova, we like to do a kind of chair with only little cushions all together, Maddalena, we put them together and comes a fantastic seat. And Maddalena never listened to him about this argument. And me, I was the assistant, I was saying, it's bellissimo. Me, I was so, you know, in love with all his ideas. I was saying, why nobody listened to him? Then now, me, I try to do my chair with little cushions in his honor. And then the concept is that then the plastic shell is telling the argument of the cushions. At the beginning, my clients were saying, well, the shell, we do it clean. And then, no, we are going to work, and we are going to work adding. Then it's been complex to make understand, but they believe it a lot, and we worked very well on it. Here, comunque, was another work we have done. Like, this was a photo that we make a lot of fun because came a photographer from fashion and, you know, I'm a lady and never, normally they get me always half off. And that day, comunque, they decided to do those photos for B&B. I said, oh, I keep this photo for always. But the concept of the sofa was a sofa that we were doing, a sofa half the price of normally they do in the company. Everybody was saying to me, even when we introduced the product in the Salone del Mobile, they said to me, the clients of a company of quality in Italia, they don't need comunque to buy a sofa half the price. Why are you doing this? I said, I think because we are in a crisis. We are speaking about crisis from a few years, and now I'm giving an answer of quality in a less price. Then I think it's important to do it. But nobody was giving me any positive advice. Is the best seller of the company, or one of the two best sellers they have. Then I was thinking, even in companies of quality, possibly the way to approach different levels of quality and approach of different then is very important. It's a signal of respect of people in this moment. Then I think it's the contrary. Now if everybody is speaking another way, then I think the argument was more important. This was a few years ago. Oh, this is the concept of a table done with Molteni. I came to them with an origami. I said to them, normally this kind of project could be done with a fusion of aluminium, but I want to do it with a cutted sheet in a certain way. And they listened to me, then they did a very light leg. Inside has a kind of cable, which is putting in tension, the whole of it. They really work it with a lot of quality in the back of something that you see so simple. Then sometimes companies, they give you comunque a big energy by there, and I appreciate a lot. This was the day that Zio Marino is there, that we got the piece. This is one day when you're doing the process of design that you got it. You got the prototype. Then everybody get calm, Echo. There are days you go, you do the meeting and you're in the half of the, then something is not working. And you have to make the company believe on that because they are going to spend a lot of money in molds, in all the collection. Even if you are doing porcelain, we are doing any kind of thing in a building. I'm doing hotels where they have to believe that I'm going to do fantastic. And in the middle of, you see from the prototyping of the room and you see many things that are not working. You come back home and you are destroyed, capito? And you have to go and to think as at Ettore, no?
a bit of this, all these things you have, and then perhaps we tomorrow is another day, we go on, and possibly this moment of this default, this is the moment of problems, they are very interesting because they make you be more humble in the process. They are very important too. That's what we will introduce. I make fun about the pieces made with them. This is a very simple piece, but I like a lot. Normally, they do in a technical way many things, but the back of the item, in this case, we work normally in steel, in ferro, very in iron, very easy. This one is in aluminium, and we did a kind of, being aluminium, you can do a kind of trafilato that you can insert the legs where you want. Then the legs of this sofa, they are never in where they have to be. And then it's like, you know, like a palafit, capito. It's a little bit piloty. It's a little bit possibly a mash of your fantasy as this architect that you study, Le Corbusier, all this. It's what you have in your mind for a long time, you know, the idea of piloty. Then they come out perhaps in a fantasy that has nothing to do. But it's interesting work, Echo. Or this was an homage to Vico because Mia was fixed with his movement, Echo. Or this was a table done with, it's only... a metal element that comes, gets the form and comes back. It's not komuka. The legs, there's a hole in the middle of those. And then it's very, very simple. When you have all the pieces of the, when we were doing it in cardboard, was so simple. And still being in the company, in the Padova, a piece that they still have in. And I like a lot because it was very simple. I came out with a cut-up, very simple. And things were working for a long time. Break time, Echo. This is como a chapter I dedicated to things that were for me a change of mind, moment where you break, Echo. And that was the hotel, the one of Vieques, I was telling you. I like a lot the two people, you know, the couple there. They were the couple from Puerto Rico that they, we were not already open the hotel, and I was putting, you know, already things here and there. They came and I did the photo in the back of this work of an artist from Puerto Rico that we went to Puerto Rico to find people interesting. It was a crazy girl, crazy, really crazy, interesting girl, very crazy. She get drunk the day of the opening, and she drank all the things of the people that were in the place. From the tables, you know, there were couples that were drinking from the... And then, when it was a disaster, then we was... But I love that girl. I would like to see her another time in my life. And she was living in Puerto Rico in the forest, in the selva, in the inside. And if you know Caribbean, to live there is not... And she works with neon inside, with a cuisine, with neon in the jungle, more or less. Then she did pasajeros, and then we arrested the first pasajeros that arrived to the place. There were photos done in Vieques. Then she was a very interesting photographer and artist. And then we were doing a voodoo little, you know, in the middle of my work in 3 years, doing all the architecture, I was doing the voodoo little doll. Like, this is my holistic, and that was the plan I gave to my client about anything, how, in the way I think the project should move, you know? And then the door, we were using the wood like this because it was the wood that was already there in a floor because it was an old building already in the place. And then I took all the wood, I put it in a place and I said to them, we are going to use anything we have here in the place because we are in a little island, not so well communicated. And it's ridiculous. Anything we have here, we are going to reuse. And then we will use other things because we don't have all the materials here. Then the lamp you see outside was a black lamp from an old space like Dracula, you know. No, you say Dracula Castle. And then they said, that at the beginning they were thinking, you know, that girl arrived, asked to keep all the things. At the end she's going to throw away everything. After 2 years they understood. And at the end of the process of the hotel, when I went for the opening, all the people were working with me, technicians, anyone, they were saying to me, Patri, we have here this chair that so surely you are going to use it. I would say, some of them, they were not. They said, oh, no, this, thank you, no. Or another one was, but everybody came inside the process. Then they were all of them with a sustainable attitude and with an attitude and mental attitude that they were all taking care of what we had there. And then we reused quite everything. And then we had other things. That was como que part of the work. Capito is not important now. We can run. That was when I did that potato, that chair. I was the year I was going to was the summer I was going for B&B in Philippines. And that was the prototype. The first prototype I've done in Philippines went to the hotel. Then became, you know, that is, you know, life is because I am architect and designer. For me, it's very gentle because I'm doing a hotel. Then you see the bathtub. Echo. Those are the prototypes done by Agape, which are in the hotel. You see the macrame lamp? They done them in Puerto Rico. Then nobody wanted to do it. We funded the people. Say, I want the macrame lamps, and we are going to get them. And they did them. Echo. Those other lamps, they were from a girl I founded in Puerto Rico, lovely. She was doing little in a bar. We went to have dinner, and there was a little micro lamp. And I said, you are going to do my lampadarios. You are going to do a big one. And then, aren't they fantastic? Then we got all the energies I could. Everywhere we were moving, I was using something, I capito. Because the way. We did the scenography. That was another parenthesis in my life. They called me in Spain to work in a classic opera and to do the scenography. I'm sure I'm not the best one for doing this because there are people that they gave all their career to do this and they're scenographers. But I did my work. It's been very interesting. It was for me an incredible thing. Four people from the studio, we've been 15 days at the end of all the whole work in the year, in the theater, with the director and the singers, preparing and deciding anything for the opera, how to change all the things. Let's be done. When we come back from there, we arrive to the studio. We couldn't be in the studio because we needed all the orchestra, the people, the singers. Meraviglioso. That was the plan of what was that. That we were using all the tools. One of the architectural things we do, that was one house I've done for a client, and this is you see, we look at the connections, the way we work, and the way we apply the things, the exhibition of O'Clock, which is here. It was very funny in this exhibition about time that we did two entrances. One entrance was a hole like this, even a bit, you know, not even very nice echo. And the other one was no signs, was a fast track. Then you had to choose. Obviously, a lot of journalists, very nice, the day of the opening, the fast track, journalists, we go there. And you had even a carpet. You know, the carpet was a terrifying carpet. And there were the dividers that you use in the airport to divide, that you can open and cross. Then when you got inside that carpet and in that door, you had an overview of the exhibition, but you were getting out in a second, in 2 minutes. You couldn't go and see all the pieces. Then if you decide to use your fast track and you don't want to see the exhibition, is your problem. Perhaps, you know, you have to understand well in your life which are your fast tracks. Me, I have fast tracks for things that are less important for me. But possibly if I go to see an exhibition in a museum, I have to get time, no? It's about time. You need time or not time, or you need an overview. You can choose. I give you the two possibilities. Then the argument was time and how much fast track you put in your life, the value of doing things in a quick way or giving, losing your time to is important for you, up to you, every day. It's an up to you, and every day up to you, I could know, so. Then that was part of the exhibition. At the end of the exhibition we had an empty room, and I did something that was in connection with all the babies that come or the children that come to the exhibition, but for everybody, perhaps it's working. I had an engineer connected with the studio, and he was very good in working in certain things. And he was always speaking to me about his algorithms. And I said, okay, now we do an algorithm with you. We did the drawing of this little paper with crosses. No, it's not working, my love. No problem. I tell you, it's the same. No problem. Was coming, when you were crossing the room, was coming the projection. Now there are many things like this. But the good thing is that we did in my studio, us. You know, the good thing is when you say, in not more than 15 days, we didn't arrive to a month. We called the engineer. We were in the studio. We said, if we want that when you cross the room, comes out a white rabbit from Alice in Wonderland, and say to you, there is no more time because you are finishing the exhibition. And comes, and if they cross five persons, all the surface react to four or five persons. I want a kind of interactive and reactive floor. And he said, no problem. If you do the drawings and you do this, 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 and you give me this, me, I do the algorithm, then we say to the exhibition to buy us a camera like this, and then another telecamera. We did all of it, was working perfectly. And then in 15 days, we became Komunke interactive. Then it's not the girl that does carpets. It's not the girl that does chairs. It's not the girl that works only in Italia, very qualified companies that they work in industrial way and is like, an Olimpo of the only. No, it's someone who is working in things and is open to live and work. That's very important to communicate that to you. For example, me, I'm Spanish, I go in summer and I meet my family in Ibiza, because not because now I go to dance Ibiza, I go because my mother grew up saying, we are in Spain is very classical, it was very close, it was Franco period, but Ibiza was a place of hippies and very, then she got a house there, very easy, and like this, we went always in summer, like this, the family was moving to something different, to something really different in a social way. Then I say always thanks to that lady that make us Comunque see things part of the year in a way and part of the year in another way. And when I, for a long time, I've been in that island coming in summer, and I don't want to work there, I want to rest. Then I don't exist, I am in the countryside, going from the back. But a person like Ferran Adrià, which is the man, the chef, which is in Spain, he's the major, he was the one who did Del Bulli, and is this incredible experimental chef. And another man, which is a big lover of Ibiza, and connected from 30 years to Ibiza, which is Guy La Liberté, which is the one who created the Cirque du Soleil. They wanted to do a project together in the island, very experimental, when you can eat finger food and you can see performers working in an art way, and a lot of things, and they needed someone to do the place. They asked me, and I said, I cannot say no to this person in that place. And we did Heart. And Heart is a space which is interesting. I don't think everything is perfect, but we did a project, and the idea was this, connecting art and doing the place. They are the three men that involved me in that team, Guy La Liberté and the brothers Adrià. And it's been an experiment, very interesting. It's not important, that is the terrace, inside, but there were two things I said to them. If we are going to do the space where you are going to be Komunque the club, I want that we do, you are going to be in an inside place. We are in the harbor, then we are, like all the fishes inside the net. Then we are going to ask in the winter to all the fishermen from Ibiza Formentera that they can do for us all the woven panels, and it's going to be done here by people from here and fishermen. Then we are going to, anything is going to happen inside this place. And this is being done by people from the island. And I'm very proud of, these little things are very important when you're doing a work, that you have some elements which are important. And then I said to them, Ibiza has something in tradition. They still have it when they do weddings and things. The ladies, they have these old golden elements, which is like only in Maroc. If you go to Maroc, you find the same thing, quite in the Tuareg. And in Spain, we're still having always ancora in the islands and in places very singular, like Ibiza. Then I said to them, we are going to create all the lamps, we are going to do photos immense of those ladies, and the money is going to become, not money, it's going to be the gold of the ladies from here. Then many things, they come inside, and then they are calling me even from there to make me stop. We destroy the bag. We destroy the bomb. We find the way. This is the... Normally, I always stop this. No, sorry, it's not on me. I got to forget to stop the phone. We are doing a hotel in Como. This is a hotel in Como. It's going to be finished for the next summer. And it's a hotel very sophisticated with only a few rooms, where they asked me, get the most quality that you can get in that place. Then we are trying to get the idea of the nature from the stones, a quality which is connected with the space, with the lake, not only with the looks. Then I hope at the end the project comes. We are doing the building too. Then it's an experiment that in the studio is coming, very important. Go. We are doing, we will see. We are in the middle of the process. Yesterday I went to Como because the client, we are doing a little boat in wood, fantastic for the hotel. We are doing the boat.
we did well. He bought a river, but it is easy to do. But now we are doing a boat. I came there to choose the way we are using the matching the wood inside the boat. And then everything, we are deciding all the things. Then I think, that's really an indulgence for the people that will come, Capito. Then it's a very interesting work we are doing. That is the view from the rooms that people will have. And it's como que part of the idea. It's not, bye, Avanti. And then go on. Analogy was another of the arguments. Perhaps there's a lot of work, Ancora, because we had a lot of things. I've been a bit slow. Bueno, analogy. There's a few items I've done. This was the idea of having a kind of box, which became a table and became a pouf. That was the little, shasen that they use in Japan that became a process and a lamp. I'm saying a very easy way. I was pregnant and I was thinking about the dresses of my daughter. And then I proposed to do an item which is well done like this. I was doing travels in Asia, and many things are doing in bamboo, and they are very with thick legs. And then I began to work on that argument. I want to work a lot much more in that argument. It's an argument I like a lot. That was comunque an argument and other things. That was comunque a research I was doing for a kind of chandelier. I wanted to do it in plastic, but looking like an old chandelier, but not being old. But comunque everybody could find something connecting with a lot of people. And I'm very happy because the briefing, we got it. Because it was exactly... is the kind of chandelier that many people that want to put a classical crystal chandelier, but you want to give them something which is more contemporary, and then you can, and we send it like a Christmas tree. You have all the little balls, all the things, and you put all the together. It's not something that arrives done. Then I like the way it's been, that's been Komuka, another thing we have done for, I'm interacting with Bilbao, a city that asked me to do a kind of jar that they are going to put in many restaurants, and then people will arrive there, they will pay the water, but it's water from the aqueduct of the city, and all the little money you pay through this water that you drink in this kind of jar, you are helping to do wells in Africa for helping the girls that they can't go, they can study because they have to go every day to get the water. Because they don't have a will. Well, I said always will echo, and doing all these little wills in these different places in Ethiopia. The city of Bilbao is doing something which is, it's a social project. I like a lot when they call us and they say, you can do this, but you get inside of a project which is bigger than you, and then you are helping. And I'm doing a few things like this. I'm very interested. And this, that was the part of all the work with Mutina in ceramic and in marble. I'm working in this company, and I became art director because the company is run by a man who are incredible, with a sensibility incredible, very open-minded, with a research very interesting. And we are moving in many ways and having very interesting conversations. Not only me, but we are creating a group of designers. And now I want to do a prize for young designers and to do a division for young designers. And I 2 years, I'm saying, I'm going to get it. Those things you have to run and say them many times. That was part of the last works. We had this space that was from Angelo Mangiarotti, and was not possible to use it, but after 3 years we got the way to use it, and we are using the place for showing the things, because we normally should go to a fair, which is the fair for ceramic, and this is Cersaie in Bologna, and I don't feel comfortable. Then I said, we need to show in another way our cultural values. Then we move it, all the concept of the company to the company. Then we are changing many things in that sector. Then we are the enfant terrible from ceramic in this moment, and we are very happy about that. That was the Hotel Mandarin Oriental in Barcelona, my first hotel, and was a hotel very complex for me because a lot of problems to solve in short time, from architecture design, and it's been a big school for me.
That is all my work I'm doing with Budri, a company that I always use all the marble they don't use for the big clients. All the B-side of marble, because marble is a material so sophisticated that the clients, when they pay for it, they want the best. Then there is a lot of B-side. Then they said, I work with the B-side. And then they have a earthquake that destroyed the company in a certain moment 2 years ago. And she was calling me at the phone and saying, oh, it's good I have you, because we are going to work a lot with all the little pieces we have. Then we are working in little pieces. It's an exercise to approach marble without fear. Because for me, as an architect, marble was, you know, quite white stone. Don't move from that because I dislike it. Then it's an exercise to break my prejudices. I think it's, as I always say, prejudices, even your personal prejudices, is something that you have to work on them every day. Then we are working with resins, with marbles, with things, and are coming things and things. Each year are coming things. This is, you know, this is a jewel. In the company, this one, they cut it in pieces, and they cannot use it because it's the beginning of the block, and the clients, they can use because it has a hole. That we put resin in the middle, and then we became an incredible table, a capito. Then we are changing the mentality of the company, and I'm molto contenta, very happy. You see other things. That was the last thing we have done with in wood, was a company, Italian, with a lot of good machines, good technology, very severe. They worked with Michele De Lucchi, and they are very open to design now. And I said to them, okay, the only thing they said to me, Patri, you have to only keep, for doing parquet, straight sides, and the heads, they have to be always straight. You can do anything in the surface, anything you want. We have control numeric machines, we have a lot of things. After 1 year, we stopped the work and I said, I'm not happy, I don't want. We didn't work for certain months, then we re-began and said to them, we are gonna do something. We are gonna use the control machine for doing really the parquet. And then I began to make them do pieces of wood in big and in little, that they are all biting, then they cannot use the normal way to do a parquet. Then we only have possibility to work with control numeric. Then the whole production is in control numeric. Then now, at the beginning, he was really afraid, and now he said, now we are gonna do a division of the company who is gonna work in control numeric. And that is, I'm proud about that, because I understood there was a hole there, and there was the possibility. Then the project was intended to go to give them problems to produce and use the technique that I wanted to use. They are all, parallel to all of them, they are a little bit curved in the surface. And when you walk, you feel the place. Then we are using resins in the middle, in between the pieces. Then you can sign the joints. A lot of research, things I like. And this is the photo of my mother. This is wrote and run in the book. They saw this photo from me. The genealogy means, you know, that's people from my studio together. Alberto, my daughter Julia. This is a tableware done by my daughter Sofia. It's not tableware, it's a coltellery, no? That one day we will produce. He always said to me, when we are going to do it? I say, I don't know. I love it, Echo. Echo is very, I think she's very talented, Echo. And these are projects that they began as a family. Then from the beginning, they were asking to you, you have to do a collection of porcelain, the whole family. Then when they ask you a project, which is 30 or 50 pieces like this, there is a problem, because they are done in industrial way. They want from you a whole family, but they ask you to do all of them in the same way. And then they say, no, then we have a problem. If they ask me to do all this with all these versions, but all them with the same thing, I'm going to break that prejudice. Then I began to say to them, we're going to do, each item is going to be different. Then each typology has a different way to use the porcelain. Then, like in Japan, something that in Japan will be normal, in Germany it's not. Then for 1 year, we stopped the conversation. And then they changed the big manager. He saw the drawings. He came back to call me. And then in 2 years, we came out with the collection. Then 4 years of relation, 1 year good, 1 year stop, 2 years of work. And finally, they did the 9 patterns I gave them. And we worked in 9 different ways. And it's only one collection. And they sell all together. That was a drama, to make them understand. But we did it. And this is important thing, that was a collection I've done in porcelain and ceramic in Japan.
And that is another work done with Baccarat, which is Comunca company. When I arrived there, I was plenty of prejudices because I said, it's going to be so sophisticated that it's not going to be a real design product because it's so high priced there for beginning. But I arrived to the company, and the company was in the company Baccarat is in the villaggio, in the village Baccarat, where is the church Baccarat, there is the hotel Baccarat, there is the ladies Baccarat. There are people working there for 50 years, and then you understand there is, they are given to you, a Spanish girl living in Italia, coming to France. One of the, they have champagne, which is made in France. They have Baccarat, and they have fashion, and they're giving in your hands. And you are saying, perhaps it's not interesting for me, because perhaps it's not Comunque low price. Then I said, I have to change the file. And I said, okay, get your meal another time. Rewind, very, very good. Exercise every day, and we begin to work with them. I went to the archive, I got in love, then I was not thinking anymore if they were doing one item or 100, it was the same, because you get in the mood, you don't think anymore. And then we did all these things. The molds for glass, they are little in Baccarat. Then you cannot do a glass bigger than this. Then I began to do those systems of modular, like this. At the end, the bases come important. They are expensive, but they are big, al meno, in some way. And they can be exchangeable. I think you buy a glass, but it's not the glass of Urquiola. You can buy this head with this, you know, there's a little bit of project. I think it's interesting in that way. And then we did the glasses. They said to me, if you do a glass, the only thing in crystal, fundamental, you when you have the real cup and then the connection of the, and you have to put all together in a little point, because you cannot use two surfaces connected, because they come out some bubbles, and that's impossible. Echo, they are get it, they connect in a whole surface. We got a new technique to get to crystal surfaces without bubbles. Then, if they are nice or not nice, it's not important. But we got a new technique for them. This is what Cartel, my client Cartel in Milano, said, I want my Baccarat. I said, I never have to do it. Why I did Baccarat? Because he said, now you give me all the waste of Baccarat, we reproduce in plastic. Then all the fantasies I introduced at the beginning of the project to the client that were not right for crystal, because you don't know well the technique. You learn in working with them. Then all these things, they became part and then became my work with them. Oh, this is the work done with Hayworth. I'm going to finish because I is just, perhaps we finish with this one. Hayworth is a company from America. They call me, they make me go and work in Michigan. And then they bought Cassina and all these companies. And they are changing all my life. But at the beginning of the work, I said, okay, the first work is going to be for office. Okay, it's going to be something in fabric because your offices are a disaster. Then it's going to be a collection of very new sandwiches of polyester, form of polyester and polyester another time. We are going to do sandwiches of only one material in different versions. We are going to put the foam and the fabric together. Like this, when you dismantle those panels, you will can dismantle all together. We are not going to put in frame inside. We are not going to put frame outside. We are going to do them curved in two ways. Then what perhaps you think is a nice thing is a technical structural thing that we needed for the panels. To get the technique and the borders was a drama, because the borders of these things is complicated story, but we got it. And now we did the first prototype in Italia, and now we are producing all the collection in America. I can tell you that's not easy thing, I capito. To work in America at this quality like we work in Italia is not easy. Then I'm very proud about, we are learning, and with them, I don't say teaching, we are learning with them how to get more energy from Canada, from North Carolina, from all the places. If I tell you all the things I've, the problems we had in the middle is better not, but I make fun, like, one day I will tell you the next time, I capito. Then it was a collection, and that perhaps I close with this. Shimmer has been, they called me from Glass Italia, and they said to me, do something with the glass. And then me, I had this idea of these materials, you know, a little bit dichroic. And this table, now I was today in my office, and they came with the big one. The big one could be done like the little one, but the table for home, you have to sand it. And I said, no, it's too easy. to do, or because they have techniques to glue everything, and I will not have any problem to glue the table and to do it in big. The problem is that the thing is logical as logistic to send that thing, you know, it's ridiculous. They said we find a way to dismantle, to do in 3 pieces or 4 pieces and to send in another way. Then it's going to be done at the contrary as we thought. We are going to think this the big table in a different way as we did the other one. And then we took 1.5 years and now I had the prototype today in my studio. And we solved the problem and we are going to introduce Forzare del Mobile. Then I'm super happy about that. Then it's every day a problem. I don't go on because we were going to find another thing to speak. Ala.
Thank you so much for such a generous presentation. Patrick, you are the only one being able to talk without stopping for hours and hours and hours. And with, you know, 60 people in front of you, you know, wow.
I hope, Buka, the important thing that I transmit to you is the attitude. So it's more important for me that, isn't it? My goals are going to be mine, you are going to be yours. Possibly are going to be better. I hope that, because I love my work, then I'm very interested to see new generation doing better. I have daughters, then I want that when I will be old to look and say, oh my God, what has done, what Sophia has done, Julia has done. Then for me, you are like my daughters, then it's young, new generation, then I hope the best, but important to translate, to say to all of you, you know, it's a big path. It's a continuous, the attitude is this one. It's the only one. It's the only one to get on. It's not important how much you're doing or less doing, but till I was 37, even at 35 years old, I should say to you, I'm never going to have my own studio. No. I work very well with others. I'm working at high quality for other people. I'm very proud. But no, my studio, no. One thing. So many things happened to me. They were on my path. I was driving for them, but I couldn't say to you that I thought I will have them. Then that's very important. It's the only important thing. But the path was very happy and very intended. Then the compass was strong. This I know that's the important thing. It's the only thing, because at the end, your path becomes, you became, you know, a filmmaker, or you became a writer, and you became the best critic or historiographic of design. And your work is much more important and consistent than me. We know about consistent is an argument of, you know, of inconsistent and consistent. But the important thing is, if I communicate to you my attitude every day to say, my changing panorama every day, and my attitude to keep on that attitude is the only thing I can give to you.